Is the screen visible? Yes.
Yes, sir.
We'll start then. Okay. So in the last class, we have seen the star delta transformation and an example of star delta transformation. Today, we will continue with another example or one or two examples on star delta transformations using this technique. How to reduce the network to the equivalent form. Okay, so it is given the example 2. In the network shown, obtain the equivalent resistance between B and C using star delta transformation. Okay, so it is mentioned that I have to use star delta transformation only, but even if it is not mentioned, I think it is not so easy to find the equivalent resistance between B and C using simple series parallel combinations. Okay, so we have to go for star delta transformation whether it is mentioned or not mentioned. So first we should observe the circuit when these kind of examples are given, which is the possible way to transform with a minimum number of steps. Yeah, so you have a outer delta connection of 8 ohm, 18 ohm and 14 ohms, and inner delta connection of 4 ohm, 16 ohm and 12 ohm. Okay, 3 ohm, 5 ohm and 7 ohm will not form direct star or delta formation. Okay, so we have two delta connections, 8 ohm, 14 ohm and 18 ohm, 4 ohm, 16 ohm and 12 ohm. Now, if I want to convert the outer delta, 8 ohm, 18 ohm and 14 ohm, the circuit complexity increases. If I want to convert the outer delta, 8 ohm, 18 ohm and 14 ohm into star, the circuit complexity increases. But if I convert the inner delta, 4, 16 and 12 ohm into star, this 3 ohm, 7 ohm and 5 ohm will come in series with the 3 star branches. Okay, then the circuit will be more simplified than what it is now. Okay, so first what we will do is we will a bit name these nodes. Let this be A, B and C. Okay, so we'll take a note that solution. So first step, what we will do, convert inner delta A B C A into star equivalent. Now what I will do, for time being I will take inner delta out. Okay, so this is inner delta A B C. So with 4 ohm, 16 ohm and 12 ohm. Right. Now I want the equivalent star of this. I want to convert it into star. I will take it with a different color. Okay, so that you can recognize it. So this will be RA, RB and RC. Okay, so I will be having RA is equals to RAB into RAC divided by summation RAB. So RAB is 4 into RAC is 12 divided by summation RAB. Okay, summation RAB is what? The sum of all the resistances, RAB plus RBC plus RCA. Okay, so that is, I will write it here, summation RAB is RAB plus RBC plus RCA. Okay, so that will come out to be 4 plus 12 plus 16, so equals to 32. Okay, so RAB, summation RAB is 32 ohms. So I will write it as 32 ohms equals to, it is 48 by 32 equals to 1.5. So RA is 1.5 ohms. Then RB, it is RAB into RBC divided by summation RAB equals to, RAB is 4 into RBC 16 divided by 32. So this is 2 ohms. Okay. RC is equals to RBC into RCA divided by summation RAB. So RBC is 16 into RCA is 12 divided by summation RAB is 32. Okay. So it is 6 ohms. So RA is 1.5 ohm, RB is 2 ohm, and RC is 6 ohm. Okay, we will add this into the resistance. So this is the outer delta. Yeah, these star delta transformation examples are little bit lengthier and bigger, but we have to do that. Okay. So this value is 8, 18, 14. Eight ohms. 18 ohm and 14 ohm. Please follow each and every step. It will be useful for you to understand. Okay. So this is 5, 3 and 7 ohms. And we have RA. This is inner A, B and C. This is A, B and C. Okay. So RA is 1.5 ohms. RB is 2 ohms. And RC is 6 ohms. Now we observe here. At terminal A, the outer terminal A, 5 ohm and 1.5 ohm are in series, 3 ohms and 2 ohms are in series, 6 ohm and 7 ohm are in series. So I can take this as So this is 8 ohms, 18 ohms, and 14 ohms with terminal A, B, and C. And I have an inner star. Okay. So at terminal A, 5 and 1.5 ohm are in series. So this will be 6.5 ohms. 3 ohm and 2 ohm are in series. This is 5 ohm. 6 and 7 are in series. This is 13 ohm. So from this more complex circuit, I got a intermediate simplified circuit. Okay. Now again, I have two options. Either I can convert the outer delta into star, or I can convert inner star into delta. Okay. Now if I convert outer delta into star, the circuit complexity will again remain same. It will be more complex. But whereas if I convert inner star into delta, then I will get a two parallel resistance in each branch in delta connected form. Okay, so if you observe here, sorry. If I convert inner delta into star, sorry, inner star into delta, I will get in each delta branch two resistances in parallel, and it is very easy for me to take equivalent of two resistances in parallel. So next step is that it is easy to convert inner star connection into delta. Convert. Inner star connection into delta connection. Inner star connection into delta connection. So I will take inner star out. So this is 6, this is terminal A, terminal B, terminal C. This is 6 ohm, 5 ohm, and 13 ohm. Now I want to convert this into the delta. Okay, so this will be RAV, RBC, and RCA. Okay, or I will take this as R dash AB, R dash BC, R dash CA. Why? Because between A and B, there is another branch of 8 ohms in parallel to this RAB dash. So just to differentiate between the final RAB and the intermediate RAB, I am taking the intermediate RAB as RAB dash. Okay. So now what is RAB dash? We have the equation equals to, yeah, RAB dash as per the equation. Sum of opposite resistances that is facing this branch that is, now this is RA, this is RB, this is RC. Okay, so it is RA plus RB plus RA into RB divided by RC. Okay, the two resistances are which are facing this delta equivalent, first resistance plus second resistance plus product of these two divided by the third. Okay, this is the logic. Now equals to 6 plus 5.
6.9, sir.
Oh, sorry, sorry. This is 6.5, right? I forgot. Thank you. This is 6.5 plus 5 plus 6.5 into 5 divided by 13. Yeah, please, one of you tell the answer.
Two point five, sir. All over answer.
2.5 ohms.
14 ohms.
14 ohms.
14, sir.
14 ohms.
You please tell for this R A B dash only. Okay. Next R B C dash. Similarly, I can write this as RB plus RC plus RB into RC divided by RA. So for first one or two examples, you try to write the formula, substitute, then keep the answer. That will make you more practiced. Okay. Don't directly jump into the calculator, substitute and only keep the answer. Don't do that, because this is a common mistake what students do in the exam. Okay. If there are any errors in the calculation, you cannot cross-check if there is no written substitution on the paper. You will not know if you have gone wrong while entering the data. Okay. Now, RB is 5 plus RC is 13 plus 5 into 13 divided by 6.5. equals to
28 ohms.
RC at 28 ohms. Yeah, equals to RC plus RA plus RC into RA divided by RB equals to RC is 13 into RA is, sorry, this is not plus, this is plus 6.5 plus 13 into 6.5 divided by 5 equals to
36.4 ohms.
Okay. So now I have a delta connection with RAB dash, RBC dash, RCA dash, and I have the outer delta connection. Okay, I have the outer delta connection with 8, 49, 18 ohms. Okay, now I can take this as the two branches. In each delta branch, the two resistors are connected in parallel. Okay, so this implies that I can take so this is 14, this is 28, and this is 36.4. Okay, and I have the outer delta connection this is A, B and C. This is 8 ohms, 18 ohms and 14 ohms. Okay. So from this, RAB is equals to, yeah, is a parallel combination of 8 and 14. 8 into 14 divided by 8 plus 14. RBC, 18 into 28 divided by 18 plus 28. RCA is equals to 14 into 36.4 divided by 14 plus 36.4. Yeah, answers please. If you have calculated, 5.09 ohms. RBC,
ten point nine
ohms. RCA, 10.11 ohms. Okay, so now I have a only delta connected network. With A, B and C, with RAB 5.09 ohms, 10.9 ohms and 10.1 ohms. Now, it has been asked to find out the equivalent resistance between B and C. Okay. So, what I want is R equivalent between B and C. Now, how to get this? Now remember the fundamental principle with which we started star delta transformations. What is that principle?
So keeping a circuit open.
Yes. If I want to find the equivalent between any two terminals, then I should be keeping the third terminal open. Okay. So I need this. You can write a note here to find equivalent resistance between B and C, we keep terminal A open. So when I keep terminal A open, okay, it will be like this is 5.09 10.9 10.1. okay, when I keep terminal A open, it is like RAB and RAC are in series. Okay, so here we can write, this gives us RAB and RCA in series connection. Okay. So what we get from this is this is terminal B. This is terminal C. Okay, so this is 10.9. This is what? 5.09 plus 10.1. So this is 15.19. Okay, ohms. Now what is RBC? The equivalent resistance between RBC, therefore R equivalent between B and C is equals to parallel combination of these two, 10.9 into 15.19 divided by 10.9 plus 15.19 equals to.
Six point three four.
Okay, so this is the final answer. Okay, so with the help of star delta transformation, I can reduce the passive element network to any smallest possible equivalent value. Now, if I want to have a equivalent resistance between A and B, then till the last step, till this step, till this point, okay, till this point, my calculations will remain same. Now, if I want between A and B, I should be keeping C open and following the process. If I want between A and C, till this again the things will be same. I should be keeping B open and follow the process. Okay, so this is how I will get the equivalent resistance between any two terminals, okay, using star delta transformation. Any doubts so far?
No, sir.
Okay. Anybody else? Any doubts you have in conversion or in taking the value?
No, sir. In above circuit, you transformed star to delta, no, sir.
Where here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, that one. If I do the delta to star, can I do that, sir?
If you do delta to star.
Yes, okay. Sir. Outer delta.
If to you star. Do it in delta to star, okay, we will get two star networks in parallel.
Yes, sir.
But it is a bit difficult to understand the network if two star networks are in parallel. You will get like this. Okay, this is one. Shall I take at the down here? At the end, I will show you that. Okay. So this star already I have, which is the inner star. With is with the values I think 6.5, 5 and 13. Okay, if you convert outer delta into star, okay, I will get this way. Okay, but these two are not in series. There is a terminal here. Okay, even here also there is a terminal. Now how we will go ahead? Again, it is forming a loop here, is it?
Yes.
Okay, so the complexity increases. The complexity increases. Even if you don't consider this terminal, these two will come in series. Again, it will form one delta form only. You will see, this is again delta, 1, 2, 3. Suppose if even if I add this RC dash, RA dash and RV dash. Now 13 plus RC dash, okay, is one resistor. Whereas 6.5 and RA, these are again, this 6.5, 13 plus RC dash and RA dash will form another delta here. Now I cannot stop here. Again, I have to convert this into star. Once I convert this into star, either I have to convert that again into delta, may not be. So it will be an increase in the number of steps. See, one thing we should always remember in the circuit analysis, whether it is reduction or whether it is analysis, the number of steps involved in getting the answer should be minimum. Okay? It is not only in this course, it is it should be in every example what you solve in the any course. It does not mean that you should consume the writings. That doesn't mean that certain things you should be calculating by-heartedly and then you are keeping the answers known. That is not the case. I am not talking about that. Even if you do some A plus B in your mind and keep the answer, doing A plus B in your mind is a step, though you might have not produced that on the paper. Okay. So whenever we go for analysis method or reduction method or whatever we are doing in any example solution, the number of steps must be minimum. The number of steps must be minimum. Why it should be minimum? Obviously to save the time. Okay. Getting an answer is an important thing, but to get that answer in the shortest possible time, in the minimum most possible time, is important. Therefore, we should be observing the networks first. What best reduction technique I can apply, that has to be applied. Okay? Did I clear your doubt?
Yes, sir.
So this will form another delta. Again, I have to convert that to star. So I am unnecessarily increasing one step. But whereas here, because I converted that star to delta, okay, I get a very simple calculation, parallel combination of these two. See, number of computations will reduce. Is it? See the terms here. There is only one term in this equation. If I would have converted that to delta, again back to star, okay, see the number of terms in the equations. Why these things are taken care? Because ultimately, if the circuit is very much complex, we are using simulation tools. We are not doing it manually. And in simulation tool, the number of steps should be very less. Whatever the method we follow, with minimum number of steps, I should be implementing through simulation. Okay? So, keeping in such things mind, we should be studying the courses. Okay? Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Then we shall move to the next example. A simple example, okay? Simple conversion of star connected equivalent network to, delta connected equivalent network to star connection. It is a simple delta connected network. I want star connection. Okay, so here equivalently I want star. So this will be ZU, ZV, ZW. I want this, that's it. Okay. So this is U, V and W. Simple application of formula and doing the calculations. But remember, this is an AC circuit which involves complex calculation where you should be careful. Okay, you should be careful in doing the complex calculations. Okay, so we'll go for the solution. Yeah, ZU is equals to. Okay. ZU is equals to the product of two impedances connected to terminal U divided by sum of all the impedances. So ZU is equals to ZUV into ZUW divided by summation ZUV. Okay, so I will take somewhere summation ZUV is equals to ZUV plus ZVW plus ZWU equals to ZUV is 3 plus J 4 ohms. Plus ZVW is J 6 ohms plus ZWU is 5 ohms. Is equals to. So what I get? 3 plus 5, 8 plus J 10 ohms. 8 plus J terms. I hope you know how to go ahead with the calculations in complex mode in your calculator. Yes or no? You know how to use calculator in complex mode, in complex analysis. If you don't respond, I assume you know and I will go ahead.
We know, sir.
Others?
Yes, sir.
Should I explain or you know how to do the complex calculations in the calculator?
Once you explain, sir.
Okay. If you tell like this, then I will be comfortable. Okay. Or else I have to assume that you know. Okay. Many of you are having which calculator? 991 ES or ES Plus?
ES Plus, sir.
Okay. 991 ES. That silver color and blue color combination. Okay. So for a moment, I have to stop this presentation and come back to the screen. Now, am I visible? Our presentation is visible. Are you seeing me or presentation?
Presentations. Both.
Okay, then I will stop presentation and I will come back to the screen. Yeah. Now, am I visible on the screen?
Yes, sir.
Fine. Yeah. Now, I hope many of you are having this calculator.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now, I have to do a small array, a little bit of shifting here. Do like this. That is, yeah. Okay. So this calculator is having various keys, and I have a mode setup key here. Okay, on the right top of the keypad, beside the turn on key. Okay. Press that. When you press that, you will observe 8 options. Okay. 1 composite mode, 2 complex, CMPLX is complex, 3 statistics, 4 Bayesian, 5 equations, 6 matrix, 7 table, and 8 vector. Okay. So this calculator will operate in these 8 modes mathematically. Did you get this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, I want to do the operation in complex mode. I want to do the operation in complex mode. Hence, I will use. I will be selecting. Just a moment. I will be selecting. Serial number 2. Now, if I select 2, then calculator will enter the complex mode. Now I can directly enter the complex numbers. Okay. Now suppose if I want to add two complex numbers. Example, I will take 3 plus J 5 ohms. Okay. Three plus J 5 ohms and 2 minus J 3 ohms. Okay. I want the answer of this addition, and the answer will come as 5 plus J 2 ohms. I hope you are with pen and paper on your side. Okay. So the answer comes out to be 5 plus J 2 ohms. And this form of representation is called as a rectangular form of representation. Yes? You know the form of representations, rectangular and polar?
Yes, sir.
Section here. Okay, so I want to add two numbers, 3 plus J 5 and 2 minus J 3. Okay, and this will come out to be, okay, it is 5 plus J 2. Okay, and this form of representation is known as a rectangular form. Did anybody go through the basic electrical lecture videos of mine? I have shared you my video, this YouTube link, channel link. Yes or no?
Not yet, sir.
Not yet. Okay. Fine. Okay. Now, this is a rectangular form of representation. Now, if the same angle, impedance or complex number is represented and R at an angle theta, this is called polar form of representation. Okay, rectangular form and polar form. Now, how to get polar form? Polar form R is equals to under root 5 square plus 4 square. Okay, so it is under root, 5 square plus 2 square. 5 square plus 2 square. So this will be 25 plus 4, okay, under root 29, which will be 5.4 or something. Okay, then theta is equals to tan inverse of 2 by 5. So this is how we do manually, tan inverse of 2 by 5. Just 21.8 degrees. Okay, 21.8 degrees. 5.38. This will come out to be 5.38. Okay, so in the representation, 5 plus J2 is always equals to 5.38 at an angle 21.8. Now I should be observing this calculation in the calculator whether it is right. Okay, so the answer is 5 plus J2 and 5.38. Okay, so am I visible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is the calculator. Now already I have taken this calculator into complex mode. I have to add the numbers. Okay, so 3 plus J5, you can plus 3, okay, plus, I cannot write J5 here, instead I can write 5J. And here in this calculator, J is I, In electrical science, I don't take I as iota. I use J. Why? Because small I is an instantaneous current nomenclature. I should not get confused with the small I of iota with the current. So therefore, I don't use I. I use small J. But while entering this into the calculator, I cannot take it as J phi. I can take it as phi J. Okay. So 3 plus phi. You can see in the upper keypad, dark keypad, there is a key ENG, that engineering key. Yes. Upon that, there is I. You can press that ENG, because ENG key will not work in complex mode. And I will work only in complex mode. Are you getting this?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
So this is 3 plus 5 I entry. Next, I have to add this with plus. You can use bracket, or even if you, because it is addition and subtraction, you may not use brackets also, but for safer side I will use brackets. Okay, into bracket, it is 2 minus J3, 2 minus 3i, close the bracket. Now you have typed this. Okay, press equal to, you will guess 5 plus 2i. Answer is 5 plus 2y. So this is in a rectangular form. So in complex calculation, one thing you should remember in the calculator, in whichever form you may entering the terms, to add, to multiply, to subtract, to divide, the answer is always displayed in a rectangular form. The answer is always displayed in rectangular form. Okay. Now I want to get that in polar form. How to do that? I want to get that in polar form. Okay. So here you have shift, and on key number 2, on digit 2, there is a complex. You can press that shift number 2 key. That is, complex is there on the 2 key. You will get this display, that 1 is argument ARG, 2 is conjugate, 3 arrow mark R at an angle theta, 4 arrow mark A plus BI. Now arrow mark R at an angle theta means what? To convert the existing display of the answer to the rectangular form, sorry, to the polar form. 4 arrow mark A plus BI means to convert or to display the existing answer to the rectangular form. So now I have the rectangular form of answer 5 plus 2i. I want that in the polar form. You can press 3. You can press 3. So answer in R at an angle theta. So answer will be displayed in polar form. Press equal to. You can see the answer. Okay. Square root of 29 at an angle 21.80. Okay. You can press here SD key. SD key. Once you press SD key, you will get an answer. 5.38 at an angle 21.80. So, is it the answer what we have got? 5.38 at an angle 21.8. Yes?
Yes, sir.
This is how I have to enter the complex number in the calculator. Now, if I want to enter the polar form and I want to get back to a rectangular form, I did not to get back to a rectangular form because anyway the answer will be in rectangular form only. Okay. So now I want to add two complex numbers. Shall I take another 5 minutes? It is there time still, 8 minutes. Okay, I want to add two. Now the screen is visible. Is the screen visible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now I want to add. Now I saw that how to add two complex numbers in rectangular form. Now I want to add two complex numbers in polar form. Phi at an angle 38 degrees plus 3 at an angle minus 72 degrees. I want to get the answer. Okay. Now again in the complex mode. Now I don't know what the answer is because I cannot calculate orally. Again, keep the calculator in complex mode. So what is the first term? Phi. To enter at an angle, there is a key with minus sign in the upper keypad, dark keypad. This key. Yes, there is a minus sign inside the bracket in the leftmost column of the keys. Did you get this? Above that,
yes,
there is an angle sign. Above that, there is an angle sign. Okay, so that angle sign is in yellow. So you have to use shift. If the angle sign is in purple, you have to use alpha. Okay, so shift. Okay, shift and this angle, you will get an angle display on the screen. Did you get this?
Yes, sir.
Phi at an angle 38. Is that angle 38? Yeah. Phi at an angle 38. Okay. Then second term is 3 at an angle minus 72. Okay. 3 plus 3 at an angle shift minus 72. You have to enter minus also here. Minus 72. Okay. You can directly enter the rectangular form. That is the biggest advantage of this calculator. Okay. You need not to convert to add into rectangular. You can directly enter in polar equals to. Now see the answer. Answer is in again rectangular form only. Okay. 4.867104 plus 0.2. It is showing some arrow mark. It means that there are some more terms. Okay. So it is 0.225137827i. Okay. So the answer is here. Plus J.22. Okay, so with this calculator, I can do the complex addition. It can be, you see, this here I have showed plus addition of two numbers. It can be multiplication of two numbers. It can be division of two numbers. It can be subtraction of two numbers. Okay. So any of this I can do. Now again, if I want to convert this into rectangular form, I want to keep the answer in rectangular form. Then again, shift and press the two key. Shift complex. You will get again four options. Now if you want to see the complex conjugate of that, then you can press 2. It will give complex conjugate. Now I want rectangular form. I will press 3. It will display answer in rectangular form and press equals to. I will get the rectangular answer as 4.87 at an angle 2.6 and so on. Okay. This is how you have to enter the complex numbers in the calculators. Okay. I think that example we cannot solve now. It is time up.